This week on Christian World News, a place to call home. These Christian refugees from Iraq have found a safe haven in Europe. Plus, parents abandoning their infant children, the desperate plight of Haiti's disabled kids, and the heroes who are trying to save them. And China's Christians used to dream of the day when God's Spirit moved upon their nation. See how those dreams are coming true 24 hours a day. Welcome to Christian World News, everyone. I'm Wendy Griffith. George Thomas is on assignment. Well, good news for a group of Iraqi Christians fleeing the brutality of ISIS. The people of the Czech Republic have opened their arms to receive asylum seekers into their country. Charlene Aron has the story.
The first of a group of 153 Iraqi Christians arrived in Prague on Sunday. Among them was Kurdish Christian Majid Kurdi and his family.
We have come here first to provide a secure life for our families, and secondly to get a job and doing something here in order to serve the society as well as to take care about our families.
Majid Kurdi is well known to CBN News. In this story from 2014, Kurdi assisted CBN Middle East Bureau Chief Chris Mitchell on his visit to Iraqi Kurdistan. He told Mitchell that ISIS gave the Christians of Mosul three choices.
They are not allowed to open their churches, and even if they opened, they are going to burn the churches. And also the Christians being asked to pay the tax. If not, they can leave Nineveh, and if they didn't left and they didn't pay the tax, they should give their heads.
And now with his family in Prague, Kurdi says other Iraqi Christians need asylum in the West because they are suffering for their faith.
Being a Christian in Iraq means giving your life. And living under the tents and camps in Iraq is something really, really hard for the Christians.
And at a time when many Middle Eastern refugees and asylum seekers are being viewed with suspicion in Europe and elsewhere, the head of the Barnabas Fund praised the Czech Republic for opening its doors.
I want to pay tribute to the vision and bravery of the Czech Republic government in recognizing that Christians are uniquely targeted and abandoned by the international community.
Charlene Aaron, CBN News.
Thanks, Charlene. A document signed by more than 250 Muslim leaders is being hailed as a groundbreaking event. The Marrakesh Declaration calls on Muslim countries to grant religious freedom to non-Muslims and protect them from persecution. It's also seen as a call to Muslim leaders to fight Islamic extremism in their nations. The declaration is the product of talks between Christian evangelicals and Muslim imams who met in Morocco last week. Critics note that the document does not address specific issues such as laws against apostasy and blasphemy. And joining us now to talk more about this is Chief International Correspondent Gary Lane. Gary, you've traveled widely in the Muslim world. Is this document, they're calling it groundbreaking. Do you see it as a positive event?
Well, it is positive anytime you can get 250 Islamic leaders together from 100 countries and agree on something. So that's the positive side of it. But I think many Christians are skeptical at this point because anyone who travels to the Middle East will know that a lot of times Arab leaders will tell you what they think you want to hear rather than what they really want to do. So I guess the proof is in the pudding. We'll have to wait and see if they take what they say and put it into action.
Yeah. Do you think it goes far enough in the call to protect religious minorities, specifically Christians, from Islamic extremism?
Well, that's the problem, Wendy. And it doesn't address things like building churches. Will Christians be allowed to build churches in places like Saudi Arabia, in Egypt? Will they also be free from these blasphemy laws? That Asia Bibi is one example. She's been sitting almost for 7 years in a prison in Pakistan simply for defending her faith. So will it protect Christians against that? And will they be allowed to share their faith? And will Muslims be able to convert to Christianity? don't think so under this document.
You know, it almost seems too good to be true at this point, doesn't it?
I think they've had a difficult rap. They look at how the media has portrayed Muslims lately because of ISIS, beheadings of Christians, the persecution of Christians in Iraq and Syria. They wanted to do something. They had to act.
Yeah, like you said, the proof is in the pudding. Well, what needs to happen for true change to actually take place?
Well, they'll have to go into mosques and make sure that imams aren't preaching a radical message of persecuting Christians and other religious minorities, hate speech against Jews and others, and also look at textbooks and make sure the kids in school are not being taught that as well.
Gary, how can our viewers help the persecuted Christians around the world that they're seeing on TV every night?
Well, I mean, especially those that are still in the Middle East suffering in places like Iraq and Syria as refugees. Many are still in tents, Wendy, and also makeshift shelters. They need food, clothing, heat. This time of year, they also need our prayers. And that's what they'll always tell you is, please pray for us. So we need to pray for them as well. Not just giving money and helping them that way, but praying for them regularly.
The longest time I've ever spent in a tent, Gary, is 5 nights, and that was rough. I can't imagine these folks that are spending months and even now going into years living in tents.
So it's been hard.
We need to pray. Gary, thanks so much. Well, Nagme Abedini has filed for legal separation from her husband, Saeed. The announcement came less than 2 weeks after his release from an Iranian prison and just one day after his return home to Idaho. In a post to Facebook, Nagme spoke about hidden abuse she endured for most of her marriage. She says she still hopes to work through the issues and be reconciled with Saeed. CBN's Abigail Robertson spoke with Reverend Patrick Mahoney, who reminds us that God uses flawed people and the church should be standing with them in this difficult time.
I would tell people this. First, pray. Pray that God begins a healing process. It is something that we have to realize behind every headline, behind every situation, there are flesh and blood people who are working out their relationships, are working out their issues, are fulfilling their marriages. And so I would say for everyone who love Nagme and Saeed to pray and respect God working their situations out. There are issues that are out there, and then there are personal challenges that people face. And I think sometimes God uses flawed people, challenged people.
Indeed. Well, we encourage our viewers to continue to pray for the Abedini family. Coming up, Heroes on a Rescue Mission, the ministry that gives education and resources to Haiti's special needs community before their families give up hope.
Hello, I'm Terry Newsom. Did you know there are more than 148 million orphans in the world today? 148 million. But it was three little girls that taught me about the plight of orphans. 8 years ago, my husband and I spent nearly a month immersed in the daily activities of a Ukrainian orphanage as we waited to adopt three sisters. I saw firsthand the utter loneliness, the pain of rejection, and the overwhelming desire to be loved. That experience changed me forever. And out of it grew a ministry from my heart called Orphans Promise. Today, we're helping orphans and vulnerable children in more than 50 countries worldwide. Thousands of children are now in safe homes. They're being educated and they're learning life skills. I'm asking you to join with me and become family to these children. Will you call the number on your screen right now? Because every child deserves a chance to be happy.
Inside every child is a hero, a leader, a friend to others, someone who helps out, who does the right thing, who dreams of what they can be, but they still need our help.
What should I do? What should I say? How should I feel?
That's where Superbook comes in. It provides moral and spiritual truths through situations children can relate to, teaching God's word to the children you love. Join the Superbook DVD Club and receive Superbook's newest episodes as they're available, plus two copies to share with others, all for your gift of only $25. Get Superbook today and watch the miracles happen.
The World Health Organization is sounding a global alarm over the Zika virus. It says the disease is spreading explosively in the Americas and 4 million people could be infected by the end of the year. The biggest concern is for pregnant women whose babies could suffer serious birth defects such as microcephaly, infants born with abnormally small heads and damaged brains caused by this virus. That health concern has CBN's Operation Blessing at work in El Salvador, distributing protective bed nets to pregnant women.
We have a team there on the ground who is working very closely with the Ministry of Health, and they are working with them at prevention techniques and other ways that we can help combat the virus.
Operation Blessing teams are also helping the government fumigate problem areas and educate people about the risks. The U.S. Centers for Disease Control have issued a travel advisory warning pregnant women to postpone travel to South America, Central America, Mexico, Cape Verde, the Caribbean, and Samoa. Well, when a parent gives birth to a child, life changes. When a parent gives birth to a child with a disability, the change is even greater, especially in a very poor country like Haiti, where children can be simply abandoned. As Caitlin Burke reports, one group in Haiti is giving families the means to love and care for these children so they don't have to give up on them.
No matter how strong your faith or how positive your outlook, when a family welcomes a child with a disability into their lives, it's common to feel overwhelmed, sad, even to question God. If and when that initial reaction fades, we live in a country with resources available to provide children with disabilities a full life and parents the necessary support and education to care for them.
But what if you have that child in a part of the world where you have no support, no idea what's wrong, and no idea how to help?
I take care of him, and later he should help me learn a skill, become a man. Normally, but this isn't normal.
In Haiti, parents often view a disabled child as a problem to be fixed. They go from hospital to hospital, trying to find the doctor who can make their child like all of the others.
A month after his birth, he wasn't acting normal, and I took him to the hospital, and they gave me a prescription, but I couldn't find the medicine for him. I took him to Port-au-Prince to find a better hospital. I stayed in Port-au-Prince, and he had to stay in the hospital month after month. After 2 years of spending a lot of money, I realized I can't try this anymore.
Haitian doctors often don't want to give parents the truth because they know what's likely to happen next.
No doctor wants to tell you because they know in Haiti how bad our situation is. If they tell this parent that true, they're going to chop those kids in the hospital or anywhere. They're not going to love them anymore.
Pepito knows firsthand the challenges of raising a child with a disability here. In 2009, his son Chris Jerry was born with severe cerebral palsy. Pepito's wife died in childbirth, leaving him with a 3-pound, incredibly sick baby boy to raise on his own. 2.5 years passed before he truly learned what he needed to know about taking care of his son.
I had never worked with a widowed father before, and here he was with his 2.5-year-old with no intention of wanting to give him away to an orphanage, and that would have been so easy for him. A lot of orphanages would have said yes because he was a widowed father, and Chris Jerry's disabilities are so severe. He wanted to raise his son. He wanted to provide for his son. He wanted to take care and be there and love his son forever.
Heather Meyer-Gabeau moved to Haiti in 2010 with a background in special needs. She was helping at an orphanage when Pepito showed up seeking answers about his son. The two worked together to find Chris Jerry the right medical care. They grew so close that they married in 2012. The following year, they took their combined passion for the special needs community and started Footprints of the Sun.
Our mission is educate these parents to love their kids, help them, and do what they need.
I believe it's a rescue mission, especially for the little children, the babies that we get. I just feel as though the parents are at that turning point of they don't know what to do with their child. And I feel like sometimes we get to them just in time before they're losing hope, before they're so desperate that they'll leave that child at a hospital, or they'll leave that child with a grandparent.
Haiti's voodoo culture often works against Heather and Pepito's efforts. That's because families often turn first to voodoo priests for help because of their own beliefs or pressure from family.
Some family judge them because they don't want to do it, but some of them did it, and when everybody says no, and they see, oh, there's no answer for this, they just give up because the way they tell them to go is not the right way. So they come back.
When we come in, we're just like, just embrace it. Let's do this together. Let's educate your child. Let's get therapy for your child. But most importantly, let's just create a family that loves this child.
It's sad, and it's really, really like slow process. It is a slow process for them to give up and like fixing and going to raising.
Footprints of the Sun is breaking new ground this year. They've built a school to provide education for children with disabilities.
This year we're going to have 3 classrooms. We'll have a 2 to 3 year old level classroom. That doesn't mean all the children will be 2 to 3 years old. And then we're going to have a 3 to 4 year old classroom. And then one unique classroom that we're going to open this year is a sensory classroom. And that's geared for children with autism and severe autism and severe ADHD.
Heather and Pepito don't plan to stop there. Their land gives them room to grow. And one day they hope to reach each child in the community.
This has been my like biggest dream since I moved to Haiti, is to have an inclusion school of typical functioning children and children with disabilities learning together in the same environment.
Until that dream becomes reality, Heather and Pepito will work among Haiti's special needs community through education, encouragement, and support, taking it one family at a time. Caitlin Burke, CBN News, Terrier Rouge, Haiti.
Thanks, Caitlin. Up next, China is the world's largest communist nation, and soon it'll be the world's largest Christian nation.
Heaven, eye hasn't seen, neither has ear heard, what God has prepared for them that love Him. There'll be no more tears, there'll be no more sorrow, there'll be no more suffering. That's why we want to be part of it.
Heaven, what God has prepared for those who love Him. Get this newest DVD teaching from Pat Robertson. Available now.
Hello, I'm Terry Musin. Did you know there are more than 148 million orphans in the world today? 148 million. But it was 3 little girls that taught me about the plight of orphans. 8 years ago, my husband and I spent nearly a month immersed in the daily activities of a Ukrainian orphanage as we waited to adopt 3 sisters. I saw firsthand the utter loneliness, the pain of rejection, and the overwhelming desire to be loved. That experience changed me forever. And out of it grew a ministry from my heart called Orphans Promise. Today, we're helping orphans and vulnerable children in more than 50 countries worldwide. Thousands of children are now in safe homes. They're being educated, and they're learning life skills. I'm asking you to join with me and become family to these children. Will you call the number on your screen right now? Because every child deserves a chance to be happy.
Kids, we want them to grow up knowing God's Word. But in today's busy world, sometimes we could use some help. The free Superbook Kids Bible app has fun stuff your kids will love. They'll have a blast learning the Bible, playing great games, watching cool videos, discovering heroes in the Bible. They'll have fun while they learn God's Word. The Superbook Kids Bible app, available on iTunes and the Google Play Store.
China has detained the senior pastor of the country's first megachurch. Since 2005, Joseph Gu has led Changi Church, China's largest Protestant church. It's an official government church in the Chuyang province. Christian activists say the pastor may be detained in a secret location known as a black jail. Pastor Gu has been an outspoken critic of the forced removal of the church crosses in Chuyang. According to China Aid's Bob Fu, Gu is the highest-ranking national church leader arrested since China's Cultural Revolution. Well, the church in China is no stranger to persecution, yet the Chinese church is thriving. In fact, an unprecedented nationwide prayer movement is taking place 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Thousands of Christians from hundreds of Chinese churches are crying out to God. And CBN's George Thomas got exclusive access to bring us that story from China.
For years, the Chinese government tried to snuff out Christianity. In the late 1940s, some 500,000 Chinese Christians were killed because of their faith. Now, decades later, in what is officially still an atheist nation, Christianity is now the fastest growing religion.
We had a dream that someday we would build a church focused on prayer for China and the world.
Ha Bining and her husband Feng Kai are witnesses to this profound move of God across China. In 2000, the Christian couple had a dream to turn this piece of land in a corner of northeast China into a place of prayer.
My tears fell like the rain and I started praying. God gave us a vision to help bring churches across China together for nonstop prayer.
9 years later, with construction on the property almost complete, the couple sent out email and text messages to friends and pastors, inviting them for a prayer meeting.
We didn't know who would show up or how many. I was praying that at least people from seven churches would show up. To my absolute amazement, 70 churches joined us that day.
This is home video of that first prayer meeting.
We were overwhelmed at the response. It was totally beyond our expectations.
The prayer center started June 2009. Since then, 617 churches from across China have signed up to pray 24 hours a day.
We have three main objectives. First, that this will be a place where people can make peace with each other. Second, that God will use this place for churches to repent and compromise with each other. And third, that this will be a place where people can make peace with God.
Christians from more than 100 countries have also visited the prayer center.
Every day we receive guests from around the world. It's so exciting to see people pray.
These intercessors know God is doing something special in China. When the communists took power in the 1940s, there were roughly 4 million Christians in China. Today, well over 100 million are followers of Jesus Christ. And if current growth rates remain, experts say in less than two decades, China will become the world's most populous Christian nation. In return, Feng Kai says God will use China to be a blessing to the nations.
I believe our life as Christians should be a blessing to others. God said to Abraham, I will bless you. I will make your name great, and you will be a blessing. God blessed Abraham. He is blessing the Chinese church.
Kai and others believe prayer initiatives like this have been key to church growth in China.
24-hour nonstop praying is not an easy task to accomplish. But it is a happy thing for us to do, to enjoy 24 hours of God's presence in prayer.
Through prayers, our heart is broadened. We learn to care for others and for the world. As time goes by, prayers inspire us to love each other.
In 2011, a new seminary and Christian business school were established on the grounds of the prayer center, training the next generation of pastors and business leaders to change China for Jesus Christ. For Ha Bining and her husband Feng Kai, this place is a God-given dream come true, to unite churches in China and help bring news of Christ's love to the ends of the earth.
This is the core of Christianity. We are all on our knees, lifting our hands and praying that the gospel will continue to spread around the world and also here in China.
George Thomas, CBN News, China.
Love that story. For more great stories about the work of the church around the world, go to our Christian World News webpage. You can find it at cbnnews.com. We'll be right back.
Join the 700 Club and get your copy of Heaven, the newest teaching by Pat Robertson.
You're going to see some amazing stories of people who have died and gone to heaven.
I was free.
I wasn't afraid.
I could feel peace from head to my toe.
I'll also be talking with a renowned cardiac surgeon. How many of your patients died and came back to life again?
Dozens have in fact died and have experienced heaven.
Call 1-800-759-0700 to get your copy of Heaven, what God has prepared for those who love Him.
And then I'll be sharing the Bible answers to some of the most important questions people have about eternity.
Pat, are we eternal beings? Do we live when this life is over?
That's what the Bible says. There's no question that we are not extinguished at death, but our spirits will live on forever.
Get your copy of Pat Robertson's newest teaching, Heaven, available now.
When you give, smiles grow bigger. When you care, homes are happier. When you comfort, the hurt goes away. When we all come together to love, miracles happen.
Life, it's meant to be lived fully. Jesus said it, "I came to give you life, life to the fullest. Life in your family, life in your finances, life in your body, mind, and spirit, life in your everyday." At CBN.com, we're taking what Jesus said seriously. We're here to help you discover life. Life. Live it fully. CBN.com.
And welcome back. CBN's Superbook received a super response from kids in the Philippines recently. Our Gary Lane has the story.
10,000 children from daycare centers in the city of Manila viewed a special episode of The First Christmas. The screening was part of a program sponsored by the local government of Quezon City. The children said they enjoyed the show. This girl said, "It's about Jesus." And this boy said, "I want to watch Superbook again." Parents were thankful for the lessons learned.
I hope there will be more Superbook episodes that will help us teach our children about the Word of God. Through Superbook, they can learn about the will of God and what's good and not good for them.
And the head of Quezon City Social Services and Development praised Superbook for bringing moral clarity to the kids.
The primary goal of the city's daycare program is to teach children good values and right conduct. I believe Superbook emphasized the same values.
After viewing the Superbook episode, the children played trivia games, sang the salvation song, and took the honor pledge. Some even danced with Gizmo.
We have Superbook!
Gary Lane, CBN News.
Aw, and we love you too. Well, thanks so much for joining us this week. Until next week, from all of us here at Christian World News, goodbye and God bless you.